I'm delighted to speak in this general debate, and I'm absolutely proud to be part of a National-led government that's getting on with the job of building a brighter future for New Zealand. We are not being distracted by sideshows. And I want to spend some time just talking about some really exciting health initiatives that have been happening in the health sector, and one in particular that actually began in Mount Roskill in my first term as a in Parliament. There'd been a group of migrant doctors, predominantly refugee doctors, that had been meeting at one of the NGO groups in Three Kings for some years, like a support group really, but frustrated that they could not get any support for a bridging program. They wanted to get recognised and registered with the medical council, but were really frustrated by their attempts to get support. That was until I got involved and I got Tony Ryan involved. When he became the Minister of Health, he sympathised with their plight, and he supported them. Health Workforce New Zealand got involved, and the rest is history, as they say. Colleagues, NZREX is the Medical Council's registration exam that every foreign doctor has to sit if they can't get registered by any other route. And the NZREX preparation program began in April 2011. There have been three intakes of up to about 10 foreign doctors each, and they have been outstanding success and been life-changing for many of those, for all of those involved. There was an example of a woman that was given to me who came from New Zealand from Russia 12 years ago. She'd married New Zealander and had permanent residency. She had a son. She was at that time in her life, she did not feel she could go through the registration process, so she trained as a nurse and qualified, but never ever gave up her dream of wanting to practice as a doctor. She heard about the NZREX program and was accepted into it. She left her family for 3 months to work in Auckland City Hospital, and her days began from 8 a.m. and ended at 5 p.m. and that left the night time, the evening, for study. She learned about the Kiwi orientated patient approach. There were actors involved in role playing, and she passed successfully at the end of 3 months and now is practising as a doctor. Now, of the intake that she was one, 9 passed that exam, and the 10th person eventually passed a few months later. So 10 out of 10 passed. It was a hugely successful intake. And that has been with these other successive intakes. And of those 10 students, Mr Speaker, 2 were from China, 3 from Iraq, 2 from Sri Lanka, 1 from India, 1 from Fiji, and of course this lady from Russia. It was a win-win for all, and it's particularly successful. Mr Speaker, we are a multicultural nation, and our health workforce needs to represent the community that it serves. Another huge exciting, I think it's been successful, is the voluntary bonding scheme, which was set up in the last term. It's been going for 3 years, and that has been phenomenally successful. There's been a total of 2,300 health graduates that have been accepted onto the scheme, and they've come from all over New Zealand. This year we've accepted 510 health graduates, not all doctors. They've come from 43 doctors, 42 midwives, 411 nurses, 13 radiation therapists and 1 medical physicist. It's about keeping our graduates in New Zealand, and that's what it's about. That and the rural immersion scheme is also proving that also. It's keeping our graduates in New Zealand. We know that if graduates work in hard to staff areas, settle in there, they'll stay there, and that's what it's all about. It's been hugely successful, and I'm grateful that the Minister of Health has had the vision to implement that type of program. I'm particularly pleased to see the patient cancer pathway improved for patients in New Zealand. We want to ensure that they receive good quality treatment, and that's timely. And there's been 4 key areas that have been worked on. The first one is cancer weight indicators. Yep, audits have shown that the waiting times on the cancer patient pathway were very variable, and the different measurements are now being recorded. And let's face it, when we know when measurements are recorded and they're published, people step up. They start talking to their colleagues, how can we achieve this target, and guess what, it happens. And that's what cancer wait time indicators will do. There's been work done on tumour standards, which is about getting the best practice services across New Zealand, and there's about 8 tumour standards. That includes bowel, breast, gynaecological and melanoma, to name some of them. The third is improvement in multidisciplinary meetings, and that is key to providing excellent care for patients having cancer treatment. But the best news of all to me is the patient pathway coordination. Well, it's the nurse navigator. It's been hugely successful.
Sue Moroney.
Mr. Speaker, and one of the highlights of the